Okay guys, so upon evaluation, I've realised that throughout my whole life, I don't think I have ever been to a general election poll and voted. The reason for this is because, to be honest, in the past, I've never been interested in politics and, you know, I've just never taken the time out to go really. But upon growing up and having my own family and my own responsibilities, I have come to realise how important it is to vote. And especially with the Brexit happening last year and I was unable to vote because I was out of the country, I felt really left out and I felt like I wanted my opinion to be taken into consideration and I was unable to do so. So this year, with the general elections coming up, there is a big push on why young people should be voting. And I'm going to go to a panel today that's run by Julie Adenuga. It's going to be hosted by Julie Adenuga. And we're going to be talking about why you should vote. So I'm going to vlog it and hopefully we'll be able to all get to some deep conclusion.
My name is Julie Adenuga, and like I said, I woke up one morning and everybody on my timeline, when they're normally talking about music, was tweeting and saying, please register to vote, make sure you register to vote. And I was like, why? I don't understand. Why is everybody not talking about the normal things that they talk about when I wake up and look at my Twitter timeline? So I went on Instagram Live and I was like, I just wanted to talk to anyone that was out there to find out how everybody else feels about voting, because for me, I love to have an opinion on something. For anyone that knows me, I like to just know exactly how I feel about something. So wherever I am in the world, if someone asks me a question, I can say this is how I feel about it, and I feel it's true to myself. But when it came to this, I had no opinion and I didn't understand why. So I wanted to get into an understanding of that and speak to other people. And the general consensus that came from that Instagram live stream with my sweaty armpits was that other people didn't really understand why either. So then I said, stupidly, I'm going to put together a panel. And then I realised I actually had to do it, and I didn't have the time, and it was math. Two things that I would love everybody to leave here today with is, one, I want everyone to leave with an understanding of why or why not you should vote. So if you don't want to vote by the end of this, and you're certainly sure why, that is fine, as long as you understand what voting is. And if you do want to vote when you leave here, that is also fine, as long as you understand what voting is. But most importantly, I just want people to understand it. That's all I want.
Why vote? First of all, you want to be heard. If you don't vote, there's no chance of you getting heard. It also gives you moaning rights. A lot of people like to moan about the system and how it's set up and how it affects us. But yet, if you don't vote, there's no way you can make a change. I know some people feel that even if they vote, they feel nothing's gonna change. But why not give yourself a bit more of a chance to help to make a change if you actually go and vote?
I vote mainly because it's a way to use my voice for change.
I don't vote when I don't believe the message and when I feel that people that are trying to tell me something are lying. However, I will be voting this time because I believe there is a human being that I actually believe in this time. So this time I'm going to participate as a citizen of this nation. So let's do it.
I vote because the future is just as much mine as it is anyone else's, and I have a chance to shape that.
Whatever manifesto wins, whatever they've decided to put on that manifesto, you have to live with the consequences. So why would you not try and give yourself a better chance of living under a better system, or a system that you would prefer, by voting? We all pay taxes, so why not have a little say into where your taxes get spent and what happens with them?
Well, I've been voting for a long time, and like, for me, I felt like the more that I have voted and the older I've got, the worse things have gone. And sometimes for me, before I came here, like when all of this was going on, there was a part of me that made me feel like, why should I do it again? And there was one thing that he said, which then made me feel like, yeah, sometimes it does take a while. It's not a thing that is going to change over a small period of time.
But more importantly, I have learned that registering to vote obviously is very important because you can't vote unless you register. But on top of it, it gives you access to many other things that you may not even have thought of. So I've spoken with Ade and she's given us 4 major tips as to why you should at least start with registering first. Okay guys, we're here with Ade and you've got 4 main points for why you think young people should be registering to vote, at least.
Yeah, at the bare minimum, getting your name on the electoral register.
Yeah.
So one of the reasons I was talking about was it actually affects how much money your local council gets. Mm-hmm. So theoretically speaking, if there's 100,000 people in a local area and only 30% of them are registered to vote, when it comes to allocating money from government, they're only going to give you 30% of that money because those are the only people that are visible to them.
Yeah.
And that money gets stretched between all the people that still live there, still need services, still need their bins collected and a bunch of other stuff. And then you're complaining that why are things so bad? Well, you're only going to get money on the basis of who's registered. Secondly, which is, I think is really important, is also about how jury service is selected. If we're ever going to see a more equal or a better judiciary system, it's about being on that register. So when it comes to being judged by a panel of your peers to such an extent, those people are selected on the basis of who is actually on the electoral register.
Yeah.
So it's no surprise if you are a young person of colour who for one reason or another has got yourself into trouble and you're standing in the docks and you're being judged by, you know, 12 people who are middle class, high earners, white, over 65, know nothing.
Far from your generation.
From your experience or any, not that there should be prejudice, but that happens and we know it happens.
Yeah.
But if your name's not on the register, you're not in the mix to be picked. And of course, you know, I talked about things like credit score is really basic.
See, I didn't know this.
In the grand scheme of things, it's actually helpful to be on the electoral register. It's the first place that money lenders look in terms of pinpointing you to an address. If you're a small business owner, if you want a phone contract, being on the electoral register only improves your chances. But beyond that, of course, the biggest one, which I think should resonate with anyone, is using your voice. Like, we were talking about food analogies, and I think the most relevant one is not being on the electoral register. It's like standing outside of a restaurant and expecting somebody to come bring you a menu. Like, it just doesn't work like that.
They don't know you're hungry.
They don't know you're hungry.
You don't enter.
If you don't come in, if you're not on the register, this is why it's so important everyone gets there before the deadline, which is May 22nd, 11:59 p.m. Please, please, please. It literally takes you 3 minutes. You don't even actually need your national insurance number to register in the first instance. Because I know that scares some people off, because if you don't know your national insurance number, you think, oh God, I can't register to vote. No, you can still register, and it's just on the local authority to find a different way to verify your identity.
Okay.
So yeah, everyone definitely get in. Turn up, #turn up, that's the right ballot campaign.